responsible. In a situation like this, where something is critical to democracy, as free, full, and fair elections, we need a public inquiry.
Why do you think that Elections Canada and RCMP would abandon it?
Well, in 2008, they said, and actually it was spring of 2009 by the time they dropped the investigation, they said informally that once they traced the phone calls that had been made, robocall phones, calls to thousands of voters, they found a phone number in the United States and couldn't investigate it further. In their official answers to the media, they said, well, this is a slightly complicated fact set, so I'll back up to say that what had happened was there was an NDP candidate who had to withdraw from the race, but his name was still on the ballot. And it was going to be a very close race, primarily between the Conservative and the Liberal. And the night before the vote, thousands of calls went out saying, vote NDP. The effect of that was to expand the NDP vote by enough votes to deprive the Liberal of unseating the Conservative. And Elections Canada said, well, there was a candidate by that name on the ballot, so we can't call it election fraud. Wrong reading of the act. A lot of people were very angry. I think that the Elections Canada doesn't have the budget and doesn't have the kind of wing to do the investigations that's needed. Democracy Watch has made very similar complaints as well. I'm not blaming Elections Canada for their own lack of resources, but it's fascinating to read the court documents filed in this instance by the Elections Canada investigator, Alan Marshall. It's clear from reading his affidavit in the investigations of wealth that he has had to rely on essentially chance and serendipity to try to break the case, to figure out how did this alleged cell phone bought by Pierre Poutine, how did it generate all those calls? It's highly complex technologically, and his explanation for how it happened came not from any in-house experts that he could call on at Elections Canada or the CRTC or the RCMP. The affidavit evidence is clear that it was because of a complainant in Guelph who himself received a call saying, this is Elections Canada, your poll has changed, who was an expert, who provided all the expertise that the investigator needed to start cracking the case. In other words, it was so random. He didn't have the internal support and resources to get to the bottom of this. And I really don't, I mean, I'm not blaming Elections Canada for their own lack of resources, but we need, you know, in this instance, we need a full public inquiry on the order of the Gomery Commission.
You'd said the 2008 Saanich situation, you said it came to a dead end in the United States.
Yes.
Could there a similar situation be unfolding now? Because I guess it was reported yesterday that now 13 conservative MPs have been found to be using a robocall service out of the United States, which Mr. Harper had denied last week that had taken place.
Yeah.
Does that then create a dead end for Elections Canada and the RCMP if it comes out of the U.S.?
It shouldn't. That's why I'm baffled that they dropped the case in 2008. When you consider, for instance, the number of times that we've seen on the news, we're always very proud of our law enforcement and investigative powers when, for instance, they see that there's a potential for child pornography. And quite often we've heard of these cases, or of entrapment of a child through a chat room where someone's pretending to be a 12-year-old girl, and you know, we know these stories. They're quite often across international boundaries. They're quite often enlisting the support of law enforcement officers in the United States to track down criminal activity. The same thing should apply to electoral fraud. We shouldn't drop a case because the calls were from the United States. Now, by the way, not all of the fact that a conservative MP used a robocall service in the U.S., there's nothing wrong with that, as long as the robocalls were themselves legitimate, as long as they were saying, look, this is your conservative supporters getting a call from your conservative candidate to say, get out and vote. That's perfectly legitimate. The problem is where the U.S. server is used with a spoofed name. I mean, some people actually received calls where their call display said Elections Canada. I can tell you that in 2008 in Saanich Gulf Islands, with the calls that turned out to have come from the United States, the call displays said they were from the New Democratic Party. They were not. They were clearly not. The NDP was one of the complainants after the election. The Liberal Party filed a complaint after the election. And the RCMP and Elections Canada left a cold trail, dropped the ball. I think it was lack of resources. But if you get away with election fraud once, I'm afraid it emboldens them to do more the next time. And when I say they, I don't know who they are. But I do know that whoever committed the crime in the election in 2008 in Saanich Gulf Islands got away with it. And I think that emboldened the use of this tactic more broadly.
So again, just once more, a few times, what is then the Green Party's position on this? What would you like to see happen?
In the instance of this specific crime of redirecting voters through fraudulent phone calls, it's a crime. We need an inquiry. More broadly, we need to clean up election politics in this country by expanding the powers of Elections Canada to be able to investigate every complaint, every time, and we need to get rid of other tactics of voter suppression, such as attack ads. We would eliminate paid television advertising by any political party or their supporters on our airwaves, period. Other countries do this, and we think it would result in a healthier climate if we got rid of attack ads on television. They could still run them on radio, they could still run them in print, but it's much better, I think, for the body politic if we get rid of the hyper-partisanship. And then we'd like to see the national televised debates. Another way to improve Canadian electoral process would be to have a nonpartisan arm's-length body to run the leaders' debates. So we don't have a situation such as in 2011, when the media leaders and the political leaders could decide among themselves to exclude, in this case, the Green Party. But over time, we need clear rules for other parties. There are a lot of ways that we need to clean up politics in Canada. We had a great campaign financing scheme till Stephen Harper changed that. But we do need to protect our history and our traditions of clean politics.
How does an inquiry take place when you have a majority government in place?
It takes a prime minister who's concerned about democracy and not thinking that this is a partisan issue. This should never be treated as a partisan issue. We don't know who did it. We knew a crime happened. That's simple. The prime minister of this country should be just as concerned about democracy as the leaders of the opposition parties. It's not a smear campaign. It's a lot of us in the opposition, and I'm sure some of the conservative MPs inside the House of Commons should all be speaking with one voice to say we need an inquiry.
And a public outcry would really help.
Yeah.
It would really help to have citizens come out and say we desperately need an inquiry. We need to understand what's happening to our democracy, and we demand clarity here.
I can't say, being in the House of Commons day after day, it is absolutely not, the House of Commons is not the right place to get to the bottom of this. The House of Commons and throwing mud across the floor day after day is not clearing the air.
No.
That's another reason to get an inquiry, is to get it out of the House of Commons, where it's being treated like a partisan football, and move it to an inquiry, arm's length, with a judge who can, with the resources that will be needed, to find out how many ridings were really affected, because there's two orders of crimes. Attempted crime to elect a conservative in a close riding, or successful crime where it actually happened. In either case, it's a crime to imitate and to present yourself as Elections Canada and to tell a voter their polling station is moved when that's not the truth. Those are criminal activities and they need to be investigated. And I don't think any other way we'll do it except an inquiry. Any other questions? Thank you so much for coming. Yeah. I did say when you weren't here, were you here with, you know, both Adriana and I are moms. We both know how to clean house. So I'm in the House of Commons now. If I could get Adriana in the house with me, I think both of us would be able to clean house.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks for coming.